What conspiracy theory do you fully believe is true? That a vast majority of Reddit is astroturfed. I'd bet anything there are bots that upvote downvote based on keywords and phrases. It's most obvious in culture war discussions. Somebody's heavily upvoted because they use terms like SJW, woke, virtue signaling, etc. I'll reply to them to disagree but repeat a lot of the stuff they said. Something seems to pick up that I've said some keywords and phrases typically associated with one side of the discussion and starts upvoting me in the same way and number as the person I replied to. The upvotes happen within a few seconds of each other. Everyone else that disagreed but didn't use the terms were mass downvoted. Again in a short amount of time. This is just a fact. Heavily moderated on top of that as well. I think the trend where you show a picture of yourself now versus 10 years ago was promoted if not invented by Facebook-owned social media companies in order to train artificial intelligence to be able to recognize and analyze how faces age. That sounds quite likely. Just like those personality tests which are just farming your data and then picking a random Disney princess to make you happy. Oh. Interesting. I never thought of that but I bet you're totally right. Just going to mention one I read the last time this was asked. The US military influenced the popularity of high school football to make sure HS graduates were in great shape when they signed up for service. That all of those souvenir shops on prominent shopping streets in London, England are money laundering fronts. You know the ones with a massive floor space selling key rings and knockoff hoodies that say TikTok or something yet have no customers except young male staff sat about on their phones? How on earth would a not very busy shop survive in Europe's most expensive retail space other than that? Also factoring in a global pandemic and a massive reduction in international tourists, who they're presumably aimed at, yet they show no signs of shutting down. They also all appear to be owned by the same person and stock the same merchandise. TLDR. Oxford Street souvenir shops are all money laundering premises. I went down a street in Reading if I recall correctly, that had 9/10 mobile phone repair shops basically door to door with each other. There is no way there's not something dodgy going on there. Agree with that. Someone paid off someone so there are no paprika flavor potato chips in Lithuania in all major supermarkets but one. 3 months ago you could find it anywhere and it was like the third or fourth most popular. I think. Is Lithuania worth visiting? When I was in high school my friends and I came up with this conspiracy between us. That the theater kids are covering up for something because they act like a cult and talk about the theater teacher like he's their personal Jim Jones. 2 years after graduating I find out he's been arrested for sexually molesting his female students. And was only found out because he thought he could trust this freshman new theater kid. And started showing him all the naked pics he's taken with those girls. Kid turned around and reported him the next day. The other theater kids went on social media to defend their god anyway. Woman with light skin tone face palming. If this wasn't Buchholz High School in Gainesville, FL in 2000 that is wild. Same thing. Upside down face. The same thing happened in my school. It makes me sick knowing this shoot happens. There is a local pharmacy in my town and I have not seen anyone in it my whole life. I've lived here since I was 6 and I'm 22 now. I think money laundering. But not sure. My own local conspiracy theory. Oh my gods, there's one around the corner from me too. It has bars on the doors and windows and a really old, barely visible open sign that's almost never on. It's a tiny, standalone building in the middle of a strip mall parking lot that looks like it was built in the 60s. The shelves are lined with dusty geriatric equipment and bottles of OTC meds that probably expired 30 years ago. The one time I went in there to grab some Advil, the only person who was there was an older man reading a newspaper. At 2 p.m. on a Tuesday, my city is notorious for being a hub for sex trafficking so I didn't think twice about turning around and walking TF out of there. Money laundering. Huh. Never even considered it. But it makes sense now. But what would they do if someone walked in needing a prescription filled? The True Creepit organization was bullied bought off into suddenly ceasing operations to encourage other closed source encryption alternatives with backdoors. Man, I used to love True Creepit. If you follow InfoSec much, and know the type of people the TrueCrypt devs were, the statements they released were very obviously meant as red flags to alert security experts that the TrueCrypt project had been compromised and no information from the project should be trusted anymore. It also happened in the midst of other groups being forced to add backdoors to their security products. CSI television shows purposely overplay the forensic capabilities of various law enforcement departments to help project an image of total competence. Enhance. My car was broken into once and they sent someone to dust for fingerprints. They didn't find a single fingerprint. Not even my own. Since then I have called BS on all of those shows. The Dom family meme was created as a PR stunt for the new Fast and Furious movie. 100% true. It's free advertising for companies and easily shareable. I haven't seen it this bad since Bird Box came out. I was actually wondering where that meme suddenly popped out from, but was too lazy to Google it. Recep Tayyip Erdogan, the dictator of Turkey, is behind the 2016 coup attempt. He did it to make himself seem like a hero so he could gain more support. J. Edgar Hoover had ties to the mob and gave preferential treatment to certain crime families organizations while crushing others. Also, his stranglehold on American intelligence made him a figure presidents feared. He gently threatened them all at the beginning of their administrations by showing them his file on them and then expressed concern over what might happen if that information were to get into the wrong hands. I laugh knowing that everyone knows about Clive and him now and that J. Edgar is the butt of so many jokes. The man was evil. They said theories, not straight up facts. Area 51 was a conspiracy theory started by the US government to lead the Soviet Union into falsely believing that the US had alien technology during the Cold War. My best friend's dad worked on base at Area 51 before retiring. Whatever that may be at the time. He never directly confirmed or denied anything though. I like to think it's a stealth plane testing range and that they use the UFO seeker to see if it's stealthy enough. Ken Lay from Enron faked his own death so he can escape the US and not serve his time for the fraud he was convicted of. I believe he is alive and well, living off the 00mm he stole from Enron. Edit, changed earned to stole. Speaking of Enron, the fact that Lupai got off completely scot-free baffles me. He left the company with $50 million just before everything imploded. And there is reason to believe he was part of the reason why it did. No idea why he was able to just walk away with no issues. TBH, there was never a shortage of Krispy Kreme donuts. When did this shortage happen? Next you're going to tell me the McDonald's shake machine was never broken. Big purses in bed with small pockets. A huge number of clothing companies also make handbags. It's not so much that they're in league together. It's that small pocket is big purse. Fake pockets also has skin in this game. The AirPod meme when AirPods were released was a marketing gimmick by Apple to sell and promote AirPods. I don't know if it was ever confirmed. But I fully believe that Netflix did the same thing with Bird Box. This is happening in real time with all those Fast and Furious memes. Phones can read minds. I had a dream about owning a baby cow and then woke up to an advertisement for cow feed. You must have googled it. I believe that the fappening was not a massive hack of all of these celebrities' phones that leak nudes all over the internet. I think it was one phone. And one iCloud account. Harvey Weinstein. All of the dirty pics were of women that Weinstein was known to associate with, including tons of J-Law. Who we now know was basically made into the celebrity she was due to her association with Weinstein and the Miramax Corporation. And the pics are either selfies or they are taken by an unseen photographer. Kept around like a collection for someone's personal spank bank. My mom has a theory that whenever a contestant on Wheel of Fortune gets greedy and spins, when the puzzle is clearly easily solvable, they manipulate the wheel to land on bankrupt. Also whenever there is a good-looking girl on, she believes they manipulate the game so that girl wins edit. Thanks for all the replies. I didn't think this many people would take it this seriously. But I have heard of the quiz show scandal. That's why I don't really believe these theories. It's more of a fun, harmless talking point when it does happen. Can't speak for my mom though. She may truly believe it. My mom was on WAF in the 70s. She got greedy and spun and went bankrupt. I bet she buys into this conspiracy. I have always believed in the bankrupt theory. OP is trying to get people taken out. I was casually about to drop the Krabby Patty secret formula too, but thank Neptune I came across your comment. The measuring lines on your detergent container are way more than you actually need, so you use it faster and buy more detergent. If your towels smell musty after you wash and dry them, it is because of all the excess soap that didn't rinse out. We had our washer machine fixed a few years back and the repairman told us pretty much this as a tip. Part of our machine's issue was a lot of excess stuff, hair soap, that would get caught and clog up the drain areas, especially behind the rubber seals. The hair we understood how to clear out now that we knew about it, and we asked about how to prevent soap from over-collecting and forming. He told us that the lines are pretty much always more than you actually need. Just put a little in and you're good. I don't know if he was right, but I accept it as fact in my head now. I work in a science lab and we use special hand soap and detergent for lab coats. It's provided on a contract basis, so we pay a flat fee per month and the soap is constantly replenished. It's essentially the same formula as commercial soap with a few tweaks, no scent or foaming agent, and a dye to detect biological substances. The manufacturer recommends we use a fraction of the amount that commercial products recommend and everything still comes out clean. We test it. The amount you actually need to wash your hands with is minuscule. Literally a drop or two is enough. That Disney was confident that Clinton would win the 2016 election, so they had already completed the animatronic for the Hall of Presidents. But then Trump won, so they sloppily altered the Clinton animatronic to look sort of like him. Edit. https://iReddit.jnt2n5sj6vm51. JPGB the judge for yourself. Well, this is just a fact. That's literally Hillary Clinton's face right there. OMG. That does look like Hillary Clinton wearing a Trump skin suit.